I'm delighted to introduce Kristina Moore, Principal Product Manager, Azure Core. Welcome, Kristina.
Thank you, Sony. Thank you, Kevin.
Tell us a little bit about Microsoft's challenges that you initially presented us with and share some of those priorities you needed us to address as part of the solution.
So our team originally came to AMD in 2019 with a fundamental problem we were trying to solve for some of our customers' most performant intensive workloads. Some workloads, such as NVAs, network virtual appliances, and firewalls, are much more network intensive than the majority we service today. We were looking to address the challenge specifically of stateful connection performance. As you know, all clouds implement stateful network function. We do it in Azure at the host. In software, we perform inspection or rules, we do the routing in software. This includes applications and stateful appliances like firewalls, load balancers, NVAs, virtual proxies, for example. We've seen explosive growth in connectivity demands and applications. The need to support large-scale connection handling became apparent. Our largest customers, who are some of the top five United States retailers, can generate huge traffic load and large amounts of connections depending upon the time of year. Consider a peak utilization day like Black Friday, where retailers have millions of customers, each with tens of transactions and connections. Each of these connections may be secured through a chain of NVAs or virtual machines at a scale of hundreds, thousands, even millions of stateful connections per second. So stateful connection handling becomes difficult with current resources. Whether they're concurrent, simultaneous, active, or total connections, at this scale, with most current solutions processing in software, you may see lower throughput, some latency, might spike jitter. We engaged with AMD to create a device with the scale of a DPU with respect to stateful connections per second and the flexibility of a pooled hardware resource. Our North Star goal across AMD and the Microsoft teams was to design a solution leveraging DPUs that could deliver orders of magnitude increase in performance for the most demanding customer workloads running in our cloud. 40 times plus improvement in performance for connections per second, packets per second, which was an extremely aggressive goal. In addition, we wanted to offer software-defined networking services to non-VM workloads. We wanted to save CPU cycles from networking functions and have the ability to offload software-defined networking onto DPUs and consolidate. We wanted to enable network-optimized VMs without limits that can go beyond the capabilities of a single host. We wanted to deliver full software-defined networking support for non-VM workloads such as bare metal. We cannot achieve 100 times performance by simply iterating software. So we worked with AMD to explore the dream and make it work.
That's awesome, Kristina. For AMD to address a problem of this magnitude required a strategic partnership between Microsoft's core engineering organization and our teams, working hand in glove to rethink networking within Azure, disaggregate SDN, leveraging the power of the AMD DPU, while enabling what Girish Bablani, the president of Microsoft Azure, calls limitless networking. This involved embedding services in the network in the Cisco Smart Switch, leveraging our programmable DPU and software stack to offload SDN, policy enforcement happening at the DPU level, and scaling to millions of transactions per second seamlessly. That is the power of software and programmable silicon, which is a domain-specific architecture, working together to deliver an order of magnitude improvement in performance and scale for some of our most strategic customers. Over to you, Kevin. Can you talk about the overall Cisco portfolio and how Cisco is bringing all of this and tying it all together?
Definitely. And this is where I get excited, because you've done some amazing work with Microsoft, and that partnership has yielded great results. And now we can take technologies like your DPUs, marry them with our 12.8 terabit silicon, and build a new class of switches that accelerate services in the network. So with a 12.8 terabit forwarding engine, 1.6 terabits of DPU capacity, and actually enabling a network operating system like Sonic in working with Microsoft, we build a new device that enables us to accelerate services in the network. Silicon One is the technology we use for forwarding. It's widely used by hyperscalers, whether it's in the front end of the network, the back end, or in the WAN. And marrying it with these DPUs gives us a device that offers extremely low power, extremely high efficiency, and can go anywhere in the network. So we're really excited to continue to evolve this with both of you.
That's great. So Kristina, walk us through the total cost of ownership and, more importantly, the power and cooling savings that you are seeing in the Azure data centers as a result of this innovation.
Certainly. And leading off with our goal of industry-leading network connection performance, you know, using this hardware, we can achieve upwards of up to 24 million connections per second with this device and 400 million packets per second. We have 100 times improvement in actual measured connection per second performance, and the actual number is between 90 and 100, but we're rounding to 100. And we've also measured 25 times application performance improvement. This may vary per NVA. So meeting our customer needs is our number one priority, and thanks to AMD and Cisco, we're able to achieve this goal. Specifically in terms of cost savings, the cost differential between a DPU and a server can be up to 10 times different. When you have tens of millions of VMs out there, this can be very significant, up to hundreds of millions of dollars. We're also able to insert these services into any of our network tiers, and we can do this without upgrading the existing server base, and we can leverage the solution by traffic steering the connections over to this piece of hardware. So, as a result, you know, we can save on CPU cycles and computing cores and steer this traffic toward our DPU and switching device, again, contributing to the savings.
That's amazing. What are the next set of use cases for this technology?
Well, DPUs are so smart. Why not run applications inside of a DPU without the need of a server? We're looking at floating NIC daisy chaining to offer limitless networking. We're looking at security functions and, of course, tunnel termination. And headless NIC, meaning we could place express route, private endpoint service, load balancers, VTAP, where the service can actually run solely on the DPU, which is where further cost savings and TCO can be attained on the future smart switch. We also want to offer SDN services to previously incapable workloads, such as bare metal. So we have all these ideas and use cases, and we discuss them in the Dash community if anyone would like to join.
Well, thank you, Kristina. Mm-hmm. This is the power of co-innovation, and the results show through what we just heard from Kristina at Microsoft. Through this collaboration, we have addressed critical performance and scalability needs for Microsoft's Azure's most demanding customers and delivered hundreds of millions of dollars in TCO savings, a truly remarkable accomplishment. I look forward to the Cisco DPU switching portfolio's continued evolution, enabling further use cases and value for our strategic joint customers such as Microsoft.